more new state stimulus checks for millions of you. In today's video, everyone, I'll be discussing how states and cities will be using that $350 billion to help the American people. This Friday evening, I will be giving away another $75 Amazon gift card. To enter the giveaway, all you need to do is subscribe to my channel, like and share this video, and also leave a comment below. Thank you so much, everyone. Thanks to President Joe Biden's $1.9 trillion American Rescue Plan, state, city, and county governments will receive their first infusion of direct aid from $350 billion in emergency funds this very week. This Monday, the Biden administration launched an online portal that will allow local and state governments to access their share of funds. And according to USA Today, the amount allocated for each municipality was determined by unemployment data. Most will receive money in two tranches, one this year, the second in 12 months. However, states that have seen their unemployment rates increase by 2% or more since February will receive funds in a single payment. These payments will be sent out within days. The $1.9 trillion stimulus relief package included $350 billion in direct aid to states and cities to replenish governments that experienced tax revenue shortfalls as businesses locked down during the crisis.
I enjoyed so much being back in Tennessee, and over the past week, I really had the pleasure of hearing from so many Tennesseans who are just celebrating having reopened businesses and music venues and public spaces in our communities. There was a lot of happiness across our state as I was there. Everywhere you looked, you could see evidence that people are ready to get back to work and they want to get back to life as normal. There's also a lot of evidence that local businesses are ready to get back to normal. You cannot walk 10 feet in Knoxville, Tennessee, for example, without running into a help wanted sign. Normally, this would be an indicator of a successful economic comeback. But here's the problem. Those signs are just not working. Not for retail or restaurants or even for the industrial sector with small business manufacturing. Some businesses are getting so desperate for help that they're offering signing bonuses worth hundreds of dollars to anyone willing and able to come back to work. Madam President, all year we've used a particular catchphrase to encourage people to get their vaccinations. We've said that we could only get shots in arms, then we could get back to normal. Well, as it turns out, that was step one.
Many state and local governments were forced to make cuts or halt spending. The legislation mandated that the Treasury Department deliver the aid within 60 days of President Biden's signature, which was on March 11, 2021. According to the Treasury Department, more than 1 million jobs in state and local government have been cut since the start of this crisis over 1 year ago. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen said in a statement, "With this funding, communities hit hard by the crisis will be able to return to a semblance of normalcy. They will be able to rehire teachers, firefighters, and other essential workers, and to help small businesses reopen safely." The Treasury Department also provided guidelines on how funds can be used. Local and state governments cannot use the funds to offset tax cuts that were enacted after March 3rd. And in addition, they cannot use these funds to make a deposit to a pension fund. Local and state governments are allowed to use the money to invest in water and sewer or broadband infrastructure. Mayors and governors have been anxiously waiting for the federal guidance on the use of the funds. In an April conference call between the White House officials and hundreds of mayors, some city leaders said they hope to use the funds for infrastructure such as roadway and sewer repairs. Most of the direct aid in the $300 billion American Rescue Plan will be allocated proportionate to states' unemployment, as determined by the number of unemployed individuals over a recent three-month period. This past Sunday, Utah Governor Spencer Cox defended Republicans' push to end the enhanced unemployment, saying that although some families continue to struggle amid the crisis economic fallout, the benefit must be rolled back at some point. Noting the state's unemployment rate, Governor Cox said during an interview on CNN that the biggest problem in Utah is finding workers for unfilled jobs, and claimed officials have found that the federal jobless benefits, including the $300 weekly boost, meant to help people out of work amid the crisis, is a disincentive. Governor Spencer Cox stated, "A recent job report showed the U.S. economy only added 266,000 jobs in April. It is a terrible jobs report, but that's what happens when we have people paid not to go to work. There are families struggling. We want to help them out, but at some point, we have to roll that back." Several Republican governors have announced that they are planning to roll back the enhanced benefits, including the governors of Montana, South Carolina, and Arkansas, with that state governor saying employees are as scarce today as jobs were a year ago. Please, everyone, let me know in the comment section below if you disagree or agree with the Republican governors. There are some Republicans that are willing to negotiate with Democrats on Biden's new infrastructure package. Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell suggested that he would support an infrastructure package that costs as much as $800 billion, a price tag that's higher than the existing counteroffer from his fellow GOP lawmakers. During an interview, Mitch McConnell reiterated his opposition to Biden's $2.3 trillion tax and spending proposal. The American Jobs Plan includes billions in new funding for traditional infrastructure needs such as roads, bridges, transit systems, and broadband, but also allocates money to issues such as long-term care for the elderly and disabled. However, Mitch McConnell has already said that Senate Republicans would oppose any measure that rolls back parts of the 2017 Tax Cuts and Jobs Act, and suggested an infrastructure bill could be paid by raising the gas tax. So everyone, do you think that we should increase the gas tax? Please leave your thoughts in the comment section below. That is the end of the video, everyone. I hope you found this video helpful today. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below, and I'll do my very best to answer any questions that you may have. Please don't forget, next Friday evening, I will be giving away another $75 Amazon gift card. To enter the giveaway, all you have to do is subscribe to my channel, like and share this video, and also leave a comment below. Thank you so much, everyone, and have a very, very blessed Monday.